So what is up guys, I'm back in the gym today. I got some quite good feedback on my last video, so I'm doing a similar kind of video today, but this time on back and biceps, which is the pull day of my push-pull leg split. So I hope you enjoy, I hope you learn something. This workout's going to be adapted like my other one to the equipment that I have, so it's mainly barbell work and a bit of easy bar work at the end. But anyway, the first exercise, close grip barbell rows, so focusing on the lat and driving those elbows back towards you, close towards the body. I just did my first warm-up set with a bar, about 20 reps, to get some blood into the back and develop a connection to it as well. So personally, I don't wear a belt when doing rows, just because I find you can get a little bit more range of motion at the top, and I can brace pretty well without it. I think the problem comes when you're rowing more than your body weight, so your centre of mass isn't going to be through your feet, it's going to be through the bar, which could have you in a more hunched over position. And then I'd probably start adding a belt in, but now it feels solid. I don't feel, my back doesn't hurt. I don't feel hunched over, so. First started doing rows, I used to stop with the bar at my knees, but now I found going past the knees and really stretching out can make all the difference on the contraction. It just adds that little bit more to the range of motion and it really works a lot as well. So. These close grip rows, I'm going for 4 sets, so 8 to 10 the first two, and then 10 to 15 for the second two. I've got 70 kg on the bar here, which is 5 kg up from last week, so I'll try and hit this for 8 reps and just see how it goes basically. So I just hit 70 for 13 reps, which is good. I didn't think I was going to hit it at all, but since, you know, I felt like I could do it, I just kept on going. I'm never going to stop at the 10 reps, but I felt like I got more because I want to train to failure. And sort of 8 to 10 is a guide of what reps I want to be doing, but if I feel like I can do more, I'm always going to go for more. But I've just completed my first exercise. Now onto the second is another bent over row. But this time, instead of having my hands so close, and move them out a little bit just to target more of the upper back. It still will hit some upper lat, but mainly it's going to be hitting, you know, the rhomboids, the rear delts, and just that upper back section. As I'm doing these rows, I'm thinking it's quite a similar cue to the T-bar row, but you're just trying to drive those elbows as high as possible to isolate the upper back, as opposed to in tight for the lats. I do think a T-bar row is better than this though, just because it's chest supported, you're in a much more stable environment, you're not sort of fighting to keep your back in a secure position. You could argue though that this is more functional, but I'm not trying to train for functionality or reach strength, I'm trying to train for mass and size. On to single arm rows. I prefer to do these on with a dumbbell, as the long bar can be a bit awkward, but I'm not complaining, it's a good exercise. I can get a good connection on it, and yeah, just a good free weight lat exercise in general. So for my last exercise, I've got barbell curls. I'll use the easy bar down here and I'll do it for about 4 sets. I do think sometimes people try and do too many sets. Sticking around 20 sets is perfect for muscle growth. 20 sets or below really. I think people try and do too much and they think the sore the better, but that's not the case. The sore, the longer you're going to take to recover, and it's not actually, doesn't correlate with, 100% correlate with muscle growth. So being sore is not always a good thing, and I think going, trying to do too much in a workout is not a good thing either.